हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्रिएटिव मेडिसिन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट
क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ प्राइमरी हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म। राइट, क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ प्राइमरी हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म। ए पेशेंट विद प्राइमरी हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म हैज क्लासिकल पेंटाड ऑफ सिम्टम्स। दीज फाइव सिम्टम्स इंक्लूड, हियर द पेशेंट विल हैव किडनी स्टोन्स। ही विल हैव किडनी स्टोन्स आर प्रेजेंट विथ पेनफुल बोन्स और एबडामिनल ग्रोन्स, दैट इज एबडामिनल पेन विथ साइकिक मोन्स एंड ऑल्सो फेटीग ओवरटोन्स आर द क्लासिक पेंटार्ड ऑफ सिम्टम्स ऑफ प्राइमरी हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म। राइट, most of the patients can be minimally symptomatic. actually these are the classical symptoms, but many patients are either minimally symptomatic or there can be asymptomatic also. most of the patients are minimally symptomatic or asymptomatic also. these patients might also present with other symptoms, like the patient can have weakness, fatigue, there can be polydipsia, polyuria, nocturia, the patient can have bony pain and joint pains can be seen with constipation, decreased appetite can be seen with nausea, heartburn is seen with pruritus, depression and memory loss can also be seen in the patient. Then in this primary hyperparathyroidism, renal calculi are also seen. Okay, this renal calculi, which is seen in primary hyperparathyroidism, is composed of either a calcium phosphate or calcium oxalate stones are seen. Now, if you see in advanced hyperparathyroidism, in advanced primary hyperparathyroidism, we have one more thing which is called as osteitis fibrosa cystica, which is important. In osteitis fibrosa cystica, here the bones, especially here the bones are actually divided, the bones are actually replaced by cystic spaces along with the fibrous tissue, which is called as osteitis fibrosa cystica. This osteitis fibrosa cystica on x-ray, especially on the x-ray of hands, the patient with osteitis fibrosa cystica will present with three pathognomonic features. One, there will be presence of subperiosteal resorption is present. This subperiosteal resorption is mostly seen on the radial aspect of the middle phalanx of the second and third finger. On the radial aspect of middle phalanx of second and third finger, we can see presence of subperiosteal resorption with bone cysts, and also tufting of distal phalanges are seen in patients with primary hyperparathyroidism.
Thank you, and thank you for watching.